22-year-old Assad Giles feels lucky to have his job as an administrative assistant in this midtown Manhattan hotel. He says life could be drastically different right now. 5 years ago at 17, the NYPD arrested Giles for allegedly shooting a female classmate after they'd both left a school fundraiser. His name and address were all over local news reports. And then he was incarcerated at New York City's main jail for pretrial suspects on Rikers Island.
I couldn't believe it was happening. It was my senior year in high school. I was about to go to college in Atlanta. I felt like I was in like a bad dream.
Giles denied the charges, but his working class family in Jamaica, Queens, could not afford his bail set at $100,000. He spent his 18th and 19th birthdays, what would have been his first 2 years of college, behind bars. He says on his first day inside, he witnessed a teen getting beat up.
It's pretty vicious in there. You got rapists, murderers, you know. You got all type of people in there. Like, you never know what could happen. You know, you could be asleep and somebody beating on you.
Finally, after 28 months on Rikers, Giles, seen here with his nephew, got his day in court, and a judge acquitted him of all charges. To this day, no one has been convicted in that shooting. Giles says he's traumatized.
If I walk in the store, it's like a group of cops in there, I will leave out the store just because, you know, I already got incarcerated for something I didn't do. So it was like, are they gonna do it again?
Giles says his residual fears stem from the fact that at 17 years old, he was held at an adult jail rather than a juvenile detention center. North Carolina and New York are the only states that automatically detain, prosecute, and incarcerate all 16 and 17-year-olds as adults, regardless of the crime. In New York, more than 27,000 16 and 17-year-olds were arrested in 2015. More than 2,000 of them were convicted and spent time incarcerated. On any given day, some 700 16 and 17-year-olds in New York are locked up in adult jails, awaiting the outcome of their cases. About 200 of them, mostly Black and Latino, are at Rikers. Upon Assad Giles' release, the organization Friends of Island Academy helped him enroll in college and find his hotel job.
They definitely put me on my feet as like a good jump, like a good transition.
For almost 3 decades, the organization has provided post-incarceration services to juveniles not offered by New York State.
I've watched young people grow up in the prison system.
Messiah Ramkissoon works with the group as a program director and believes a successful transition back into society is essential in reducing recidivism. He also points to studies showing that the human brain is highly malleable up until your mid-20s, and that until that age, the parts of our brains responsible for decision-making and impulse control aren't fully developed.
That 16, 17-year-old age bracket, 18, sometimes older, the brain is still developing. So what this environment does is shapes the nature of the being. So you have young people who come out and they tell you, like, I'm not afraid to go right back because part of their psyche and the way they think and, you know, development of the brain has been composed behind these bars.
He's been through a lot during these 16 months that he's been incarcerated.
On a recent Tuesday morning at the group's headquarters in Harlem, the staff meet to discuss other cases as part of their new Youth Reentry Network, funded by a $3 million a year grant from the New York City Department of Corrections.
He's not in contact with anyone in terms of family.
As part of this new program launched in November, these youth advocates act as the point person for every 16 and 17-year-old incarcerated at Rikers, offering them support by helping their lawyers expedite their cases, reconnecting them to family members, and keeping tabs on teens if they get released.
Anytime a child is arrested, cuffed, and held, whatever system you're in, it's traumatizing.
Chris Pahigian is executive director of Friends of Island Academy.
The role of the reentry network or any system of aftercare support is that we know coming out of the box where it is you're going to go home to and to have a plan in place and to help navigate and implement that plan once they get home.
There's also emotional and mental health counseling. On a typical night here, formerly incarcerated people meet to discuss their experience being locked up as an adolescent.
For decades, we have been criminalizing young people, locking young people up in masses. So now we have generations of people who carry the stigma and who carry the trauma of that process.
That stigma and trauma has been on the rise since the 1970s, when the federal government and states began adopting harsher sentencing laws for drug crimes, including for adolescents. In the 1990s, the advent of mandatory minimum sentences and the expansion of juvenile transfer laws increasingly shifted control of juvenile cases from family courts to regular criminal courts. That decade, the number of juveniles incarcerated in adult jails quadrupled. But since 2000, spurred by the research on the social and economic costs of incarcerating youth, like increased suicide rates and recidivism, state legislatures changed their laws, and by 2014, those numbers decreased by more than half.
The fundamental difference is that in the family court, that child who is charged with a crime is viewed as somebody who is a child for whom elements of rehabilitation and support must be put in place.
Three quarters of 16 and 17-year-olds who are arrested in New York State face misdemeanor charges for offenses like possession of marijuana or vandalism. But one quarter are prosecuted as adults for more serious felony charges, like robbery and drug trafficking. Arguments for raising the age of adult criminal responsibility from 16 to 18 have fallen flat in the New York State Legislature each time proposals have come up for a vote in the past 3 years.
What I'm suggesting is that we just don't change an entire system until we know more.
Patrick Gallivan chairs the Crime Victims and Corrections Committee in the New York State Senate. He's also a former sheriff of Erie County, which includes Buffalo. He's voted against raising the age.
People are saying that, geez, our young people shouldn't be incarcerated. Our young people deserve a chance. Children should be treated different than adults. Who can say no to that? Just on the premise, anybody who raises question can be looked at as a big bad ogre when they're raising questions. But that isn't the case at all.
Gallivan argues that 16 and 17-year-olds are already treated differently than adults in that their criminal records can be sealed. And due to the Prison Rape Elimination Act passed by Congress, all federal and state prisons must separately house juveniles under 18 from adults.
The argument that I've heard from Raise the Age advocates is that just touching the adult criminal system can have a long-lasting impact. You know, being housed at a place like Rikers for 18, 19 months while you're waiting for your trial to start.
The bullet has the same impact. Recently, in this Erie County area, an individual was convicted of crimes that were committed when he was over 16 but under 18 years old. He killed two people, shot six others. Well, my gosh, should an individual like that be subjected or get a lesser sentence?
Some of our most violent offenders are teenagers.
Michael Flaherty, who just stepped down as the acting district attorney for Erie County, says requiring all juvenile cases to be heard in family court would strip away a prosecutor's tools to adequately prosecute teens in criminal court when needed.
Under the current system, I have a voice. I have a say. I get to use my professional judgment. What we don't need is a uniform policy which presumes that the best interests of the offender trump public safety or trump the justice system. We dismiss charges all the time just on reviewing the papers and the facts. I have no control over what happens in family court.
With no forthcoming changes in state law, and as part of reforms in response to a federal investigation documenting widespread abuse of juveniles at Rikers, New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio announced last year that 16 and 17-year-olds would be moved off of Rikers by 2020, and he ended solitary confinement for anyone younger than 21. The New York City Department of Corrections is subjecting Rikers guards to more rigorous training, and in addition to the jail's partnership with the Friends of Island Academy, it recently increased educational programming for juveniles. Friends of Island Academy plans to push this year for the state to raise the age of adult criminality to 18. For now, the organization will continue supporting youth transitioning out of incarceration with adults, like Assad Giles, something he believes helped keep him from ever being arrested again.
I could have got out, you know, with like a jail mindset, you know, like, F everything, or I don't want to do this, I don't want to go back to school, I just want to stay in the streets, I want to do this. But I didn't want that for myself, so I contacted friends and just got ready to make my life better.